Welcome, my dear students. Hope you are keeping fine. Same time, you have to read the chapters which are already taught. Revised question answers are there. It is in the end of the chapters. Each chapter, it has given some of the revised question answers. That also you have to learn. And I think that you are writing the short notes also. As it is given some of the exercise and question answers in the end of the chapter, that also you have to read and you have to learn it. Maintain the copy. Each chapter, please complete it on time. Otherwise, it will be a burden for you later. So, we are learning the sixth chapter. Part 1, sixth chapter. Natural vegetation we are completed. That we know, last session we were discussing about the different types of natural vegetation found in India. Among that, the first type we have completed, tropical monsoon type of climate. Tropical monsoon, also known as rainforest or the tropical evergreen forest, which found in the equatorial part of the world, in India, Andaman Nicobar Island, western part of Western Ghats, and in northeastern hill cities found. Temperature, it is needed 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. Temperature is needed for the growth of tropical evergreen trees. Rainfall more than 200 centimeter, it is needed. And these are the things we have discussed last topic. Now we will continue with the next type of vegetation found in India, that is tropical monsoon type of climate or tropical deciduous type of climate. Tropical deciduous type, or it is also known as the deciduous monsoon type. It's the main characteristic features and the areas we will see with the help of the slides. Good morning to all. In this session, we are continuing with the topic, that is the different type of vegetation in India. Last session, we were discussed about the forest type based on variation in rainfall and relief features. Among the six relief features, we have studied first one, that is the tropical evergreen forest or tropical monsoon type of forest. These are the thick forests, thick and dense forest, which is found in the heavy rainfall areas of India, like Andaman Nicobar Islands, western part of Western Ghats, and in northeastern hills, Assam hill area, evergreen it is, not shedding its leaves. And it's a climatic condition which is needed for 200 centimeter more than annual rainfall is needed. 200 centimeter to 300 centimeter rainfall it is needed. And temperature, it is 25 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. That much we have described. Hereafter, there is remaining six more vegetative types are there that we will be discussing today. We have to make it an interesting topic by following the areas wherever there is India's topographical area, wherever there is different type of vegetation and trees can found. Such a way, if you are understanding, means it will be an interesting topic. So that we have to move further with the different vegetative types of India. So tropical evergreen, as we studied here, next one, second type, it is tropical deciduous type of forest. Tropical deciduous type of forest, also known as deciduous monsoon forest, tropical deciduous type, also known as deciduous monsoon type of forest, or the vegetation. First one, it is tropical monsoon type or tropical evergreen type. Second, which we are going to study now, that is deciduous monsoon forest or tropical deciduous forest. As we have studied the annual rainfall and temperature related with the geographical condition which is needed for the growth of the first type of vegetation, here also we will study the climatic condition, that is the annual rainfall. You have to remember 150 centimeter to 200 centimeter rainfall getting areas of India. That means heavy rainfall is not there, moderate rainfall getting areas of India. That means adjacent areas of tropical evergreen forest or heavy rainfall area, wherever it is getting, there that tropical deciduous forest grows. You can write briefly, shortly, annual rainfall 150 centimeter to 200 centimeter rainfall area. Tropical monsoon forest, it is more than 200 centimeter rainfall is needed, but the tropical deciduous forest needs 150 centimeter to 200 centimeter. And see the temperature, it is 24 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius temperature is needed for the growth of tropical deciduous. Let's recall your study related to the first tropical monsoon type. It was needed 25 degrees Celsius to 27, but it is tropical deciduous second type, it is needed temperature 24 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Main characteristics of this type of forest, that is, these forests, tropical deciduous meaning itself, it is not shedding its leaves. Sorry, it shed its leaves. Tropical monsoon not shed its leaves. Tropical deciduous type of forest, it is shedding its leaves for 6 to 8 weeks. That means in the transition period of seasonal changes, whenever it is taking place during the springs and the early summer months, March, April months, when sufficient moisture for leaves not available, that time it is shedding its leaves, almost 6 to 8 months. And also that time it will be looking bare trees, leaves will not be there, it will not retain the leaves. Subsoil water is not enough for the trees to retain the leaves. That is why during this season, the autumn season or the spring season, forest of north temperate zone, deciduous zones, north temperate deciduous zones shed their leaves in autumn season. And other part of the country during summer season, it is just before the summer, beginning of the summer months, April and May, it is shed its leaves. So most of the Indian land areas are covered with the tropical deciduous forest only. And its importance are, it is economically very valuable, woods are giving, timber it is giving. Economically, as it is very yielding valuable timber, and several other forest products are getting from this type of tropical deciduous or the deciduous monsoon type of forest. In India, it is known as deciduous monsoon type, deciduous monsoon. And it is occupying larger area than the evergreen forest found. More than that, we were discussing that the tropical monsoon, it is existing in the southwestern part, that is western part of Western Ghat and the northeastern hill, Assam hills only, wherever heavy rainfall getting area, monsoon from area. But the adjacent areas of this tropical monsoon forest found, evergreen forest found, they are the tropical deciduous or the deciduous monsoon forest can found. And last point, it is found in pure stand. Pure stand means the trees are the same type, not the variety of trees cannot be found. It is written here poor stand, not poor stand, it is pure stand. It is printing mistake only. Pure stand, P-U-R-E, pure stand it is. Pure stand means the same type of forest can found in deciduous area. That means mixed forest cannot be found. Coniferous, tropical evergreen, such a type of different varieties of trees cannot be found. Deciduous monsoon forest have trees found in pure stand. The same types of trees can be found. And it's a main species also we can, types of trees we can found, its uses are also important. Sometimes question can ask, name some of the tropical deciduous type of trees found in India and give it any one or two uses. First one, it is teakwood. Teakwood is universally used for making the furniture, construction of houses, doors, windows and shipping building. Shipbuilding industries also. So it is a hardwood, universally it is using, and it is a hardwood, that is why furniture work it is using, and that is why it is a valuable wood, and it, for the shipbuilding also it is using teakwood. And also teakwood can resist white ants, another important quality of this wood, that is why it is worldwide acceptance are there. And teakwood does not erode or rust iron nails. It will not cause the rust in iron. That is also another thing, it cannot decay. And teakwood does not erode in or rust iron nails. Teakwood is found in the forest of Maharashtra mainly. Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Assam, Orissa, Bihar and Tamil Nadu region. So, next type it is sal. It is very hard and resistible to white ants. It is resistible. And also it occurs in a large pure stand area. Single species it can found. It is not a mixed. Wherever there is salwoods are there, a large area widely it is with the salwood only. And it is used for making railway sleepers and house building. So sal, it is used to make the railway sleepers and house building. And it is found in the forest of North, Central and Northern India. States like Bihar, UP, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh and Tripura, it seems. Another one, it is sandalwood. Sandalwood as a tropical deciduous forest, it is very costly and it is used in perfumery and cosmetics industries. It provides sandalwood for handicrafts and other curving industries. And that is why it is economically very important, sandalwood. And semul, this is very soft and white type of wood, timber. And it is used to make, semul, it is used to make matchboxes, toys and packing cases. Semul, another type of tropical tree. And myrobalan, it is used to tan the leather and for dyeing purpose, tanning the leather. So myrobalan, it is a very important deciduous forest, costly also, and it is getting leather and a dyeing purpose it is using. I think you remembering that red cube branches, the areas in South America, nearby Grand Chaco areas, Argentina, there it is mainly found the such a type of myrobalan, red cube branches areas of South America, we have studied. So myrobalan is the next type. In India it is found in Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana areas. Even in some part of Karnataka also it is found. Myrobalan, another one. Palas, Mahua, Tendu are the other types of tropical deciduous forest which can found in India. And the last type of deciduous forest found in India, eucalypts. Eucalypts are varieties of eucalypts are there. In Australia's chapter, last year we have studied, few years back we have studied eucalypts. Five 100 varieties of eucalyptus trees are there in different part of the world, especially in Australia. In India, also different varieties of eucalyptus trees are there. It's very useful also. It's a lofty status, elevated status, lofty, elevated height it is. It is growing as a single tree without the branch, that is why it can use it for different purpose. Some of the area people, they are making to use the eucalypts for the house making. And this eucalypt wood is raw material for the paper industry also. Eucalypts oil is used for medical purpose. And other trees found in this type of forest are, other than this, other than the teak, sal, sandalwood, samul, myrabalan, palas, mahua, tendu, eucalypts, bedal trees, amla, laurel, and chicory trees are also found in this region. So these are the important types of trees which can found in tropical deciduous, second type of vegetative type in India. Main trees and its use, minimum 3-4 you have to remember. Among that, myrobalan is, it is important, teakwood it is important, you have semul also important, the species of trees and its uses you have to remember. So second type also completed. Tropical deciduous forest, its climatic condition which are needed for the growth of tropical deciduous, annual rainfall 150 to 200 centimeter, temperature 24 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius, and characteristics, it is shedding its leaves deciduous, that is why, and transitional area mostly it is found. Economically important, it is found in Puristan, P-U-R-E, Puristan. These are the main points. And the areas wherever the tropical deciduous type of trees are found in India. Areas and the states. Deciduous forest found in the Western Ghats, surrounding areas of the belt of evergreen forest. I told you, the adjacent areas of evergreen forest, tropical monsoon type of forest found, that area, surrounded areas, both on eastern and the western slopes areas, Shivalik or the northeastern hill areas and the Chota Nagpur area, it can found. Forest found in the states like Bihar, UP, Odisha, MP, Manipur, Tripura, Mizoram, Assam and part of Andaman Nicobar Islands also, the tropical deciduous trees can found. In India, this type of tropical deciduous type of trees are only mostly found, commonly found. Large area it is found, tropical deciduous forest only. With the help of the maps, we can just revise it. See here, in the map it is given, the dark green color is showing the first type, evergreen trees, tropical evergreen or the tropical monsoon, the Western Ghat area. And in the Assam Hill region also, with the dark green color, it is shown here, the evergreen. And with the light color, the major part of India, Western Ghats eastern side towards leaving the Deccan Plateau, the interior Deccan Plateau area, other than most of the area covering Tamil Nadu, Kerala's eastern side, even Karnataka some part, Maharashtra some part, and the total areas, Chota Nagpur area, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal, part of West Bengal, even UP, our state, and the North Indian plains, most of the area, the deciduous type of forest can be found. So, remember, it is the largest group of vegetation found in India. Tropical deciduous forest. One word question can ask. So, this type of forest can be found in tropical deciduous forest. It is not thick like the tropical evergreen. Shed its leaves, bare leaves, trees you can find here. If it is clear, means otherwise you can log on to the Google and you can search some of the images. There you can find a lot of trees and the vegetation, different part of the world, the vegetative type. If you are logging, the study will be easy. So such a type of vegetation. In India, these are the parts you have to remember. Mainly you have to remember the adjacent areas of surrounding areas of the evergreen forest found there only. Leaving the evergreen forest area, you have to mark during the exam in the map. Sometimes question is asking, mark the area wherever there is tropical deciduous type of forest can hold. You can mark such a way. Any area. Mark an area is asking means an area. One area asking means you can mark any one of the area related with this. I think it is clear. Second type of forest it is vegetative types in India. After evergreen type, tropical evergreen or tropical monsoon. After that, tropical deciduous forest. Remember, tropical deciduous also known as deciduous monsoon in India. You should not confuse with these points. That is what. Then, moving to the next topic, that is the third type of forest, the desert and semi-desert vegetation. Main species are, first it was given here, that means these are important. Almost all the question paper it is asking, which are the important desert type, or name the important desert or semi-desert vegetation. Desert or semi-desert, same only. Main important, they are babool trees. We will see its uses. Date palm, kail, it's very important. What are the uses of kail trees? Last year also one of the question it is asked under kail and bird, cacti type, different types of cactis are there. It is found in the desert area or the dry area. Dry areas of India also, even these such type of trees can found. That is why it is called the desert type of vegetation. And so that the climate in India, it can be thar desert area suitable for the growth of this. Average climate or the rainfall, it is less than 25 centimeter is needed. Only dry area it is growing, that is why rainfall it is less enough. Remember, other two, first two we studied that more than 200 centimeter, and also second or deciduous type it is needed 150 to 200 centimeter rainfall it is needed, but the desert type it is needed less than 25 centimeter. Average temperature it is 25 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. So tropical evergreen also needed 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. You can compare and study, then it will be easy. But the second type it was needed, are you remembering? The second type, tropical deciduous forest, it was needed 24 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius, 24. But the third one also 25. First one, tropical evergreen, and the third one, desert semi desert, also 25 to 27 degrees Celsius climate. Characteristics, seropites. These trees are known as seropites type trees. What is this meaning, seropites? I think you have studied in biology. That is, plants that grow in this type of vegetation are called seropites. They either have very thin leaves or no leaves. That is what it is called, seropites type of trees, which is found in desert area. Seropites. And they are having the strong roots and stems where it is storing the water. These desert type of trees are storing the water in their roots and stems. They are also natural. Means their photosynthesis process it is taking place during the night, because to store the water. During the daytime, the photosynthesis process taking place, water lost will be there. That in order to prevent that, that is why. So it is called seropites type, storing the water on their roots. And that is why, in order to adapt with the drought condition, they are having very thin leaves or no leaves. That is why it is seropites. And second characteristic of desert type of forest cover it is, it is covered by sharp spines or the thorns. Most of the cacti that found with the thorns or the spines will be there. Sharp thorns will be there. Another characteristics. And also long roots and thick fleshy stems will be there. That means in order to catch the water from the different areas, the long roots having, and in order to adapt with the drought condition, fleshy stems will be there. They are the trees are storing the water. So these are the common characteristics of desert type. You have to remember these stems, seropites, sharp spines or the thorns, long roots. I think it is very simple only, you have to remember that. Now, the different types of trees which we can find in this area. First one, it is babool trees. Babool, it is also known as Acacia arabica. It is found in mostly in the Gulf countries, that is why it is known as Acacia arabica. Babool. And it is mostly most important tree for the Arabian region. And second type, it is kai trees. It is a very strong tree, tough and hardwood it is. That is why it is used for fuel for the local area. They use it as a fuel, kai. Date palm also there. Kai trees are yielding gum also, and its bark or the skin, it is providing material for tanning hides and skins. That is why kair and bur trees are used to get the gum, and it is providing its skin or the bark, it is providing hides and leather. That is why it is very important. Its uses you have to remember. So cacti types are also there. Different types of cacti trees are also found here. This is the third type of vegetation found in India. And its areas wherever in India it is found, that we will be studying here. So in India, based on the map, in Thar Desert, Rajasthan, Western Rajasthan, part of the North Western Haryana also can found. Even in Gujarat region also, some part of Gujarat region also, Thar Desert area mostly found. You can remember easily with the red mark it is given here, there you can. Not only there, in Ladakh area, which is given in the map, Ladakh area with the red color which is shown, there is also Ladakh, temperate desert area that is. There is also can found the desert type of forest in India. Desert or semi-desert it is called. I think it is clear. These are the area you have to mark in the map. If it is asking in the exam, mark an area where there is dry vegetation or the desert type of vegetation found in India. These you can mark. Clear? So desert vegetation is such a way it is found. Cacti type it is. Thus trees are very less only. Dry area it is found. The desert type of vegetation found in Kutch area, Gujarat area, Kutch, Saurashtra area, this area. Southwest Punjab, I told you, Rajasthan and a dry part of Deccan also. Even in dry part of Deccan also, it can found in India. And the next type it is, after completing third type, scarves and thorn forest, it is the fourth type which is found in India. Almost a semi-desert area it is found. The rainfall it is needed less than 100 centimeters is enough. Wherever there is less than 100 centimeter, desert type it is less than 25. Some of the book it is given less than 50 centimeter also. But the scarves and thorn forest it is found less than 100 centimeter. Temperature 25 degree Celsius to 30 degree Celsius. Till now we are not discussed any of the area temperature which is needed for any type of vegetation 30 degree Celsius. 25 same only, 25 to 30 degree Celsius. Why I am saying compare and study, otherwise you will get confused later. All three we have discussed already. This is the fourth one. These four types are based on the rainfall only. Variation in rainfall based on that only it is found in India. First type, tropical evergreen, 25 to 27 degrees Celsius temperature is needed. Second type, it is 24 to 27, it is needed temperature, and third type, desert type, it is needed, I remember, 25 to 27 degrees Celsius only, same only, commonly. And the fourth type, it is scarves, it is needed 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius, 31st time. Characteristics are, it is stunted type of trees, the short type of trees, long scarves are there, and also it is long roots are there, like the desert type, it is also needed to store the water, that is why stretching its roots, and the thorns are also will be there, spines or the thorns also will be there. The main type it is found in India, that is sky type, it is uses also we found that bark of its kair, it is using for tanning the hides and the skins, it is using. Kair trees are also yielding the gum also, the importance you have to remember here. So this is the fourth type based on the variation of rainfall it is. And where is the areas, which areas in India it is found? Kair type, it is shown here with the good picture in the screen you can see. This type of forests are found in the states of northwestern part of the country. Northwestern part of the country it can found. Rajasthan, northwestern part, same the desert type wherever it is found. In the map it is shown here, there also you can see that with the blue color both in Deccan Plateau region, interior Deccan Plateau region, at the same time the part of major part of the Thar desert, Rajasthan, Gujarat area, Kutch area, there it is scarves type of adjacent areas of a desert type of vegetation found that areas also. You have to remember that here we cannot keep any border, any boundary is not there, transitional area it is, that is why it is extending here and there some little bit. So here it is giving with this red color lines, wherever it is shown, there you can mark where the scarves and thorn type of forest found in India, this area. Where there is showing with the red lines, there it is found. Once again, you can see that one. So these are the four types of forest found in India. Now, moving to the fifth type, altogether six types are there. Fifth type of trees, that is the mountain forest. Mountain forest also known as mixed forest. So it is needed rainfall as usual, it is 150 to 250. 150 to 200 it is needed for second type, that is tropical deciduous. The mountainous type it is needed 150 to 250. It is also known as mixed forest as it is existing different types of forest trees. Even the coniferous, deciduous, evergreen forest are found, that is why it is mixed forest. It is also known as mountain area. The altitude level almost 1500 meter to 3300 meter, or 1500 meter to 3300 meter height areas, hill stations, these mountainous forest. Mountain itself, it's showing that area it is found in India. Temperature, it is almost less than 20 degrees Celsius, less than 20 degrees Celsius. Only this type, mountainous forest. Less than 20 is enough. As you know, mountain area, hill stations, higher altitude, there will be less temperature. That is why the mountainous type it can found. It is adapted to the situation, that is why mixed forest we can found here. Mixed deciduous coniferous, cone type of trees. Fir Douglas, it is very silver fir. It is one of the most common example for the coniferous trees. So mixed type. Even the evergreen also, some part of the mountainous forest can found, deciduous also can found. And it is occurs in the transitional zone. Transitional zone means wherever there is covering even the evergreen trees, deciduous trees found, that area it can see, transitional zone. Main types are chip pine is the main type of mountain forest. It is used. Chip pine is used to extract the resin and turpentine. Turpentine is used as a raw material for the paint industries, paint making. So one of the raw material which is using this tree only, chip pine trees are only. And it is provide softwood also. users who are making the packing cases for the tea also. It's very valuable, economically very important this turbine, and it is found in Punjab, UP and Kashmir, the mountain areas of the states we can form turbine. It's a use you have to remember, important it is, making the turpentine and also resin making it is using. And it is, as it is a softwood, it is using for the making of packing cases for the tea. Silver fir, it is the second one. It is a tropical coniferous tree which is found in the higher altitudes of India, used for paper, pulp, matchboxes and packing cases. It is using paper, pulp and as it is a softwood tree, it is using. Deodar is the next type. It is deodar. Deodar or the devadar, it is known as devadar too in Hindi, I think. Devadar, deodar. It is very zended type of tree. That means strong smell it is there. Durable it is. Long lasting it is. Very costly it is, deodar. It is used for railway sleepers, making the railway sleepers and house construction also. Is costly wood it is, timber. It is found in Himachal Pradesh and Kashmir. The higher altitude of Himachal Pradesh and Kashmir it is using. So these are the main trees which we can found in the mountainous or the mixed type of trees. Important point you have to remember. Moving to the areas wherever it is found. Areas like India's higher altitude, already I told you, it is found in the higher altitude like temperate zones of the Himalayas from Kashmir to Assam at varying altitude level, and in south Nilagiri hills in Tamil Nadu, in Kerala Annamalai and Anamudi hills, the Western Ghats higher peaks, we can see this type of trees. The mountainous type trees can found here. It is marked very correctly. You can see in the map. See these areas, Himalayan ranges, and even the Sikkim areas. The higher altitudes of northeastern hills are also, and Nilagiri hills. It is marked here. Annamalai hills in Kerala. It is marked here. Mountain type. Hill station areas it is found with the red color. It is marking here. You can see here red color it is marked. Next type, the tidal or mangrove or littoral forest. Last type, it is sixth type. Mountainous type, this type, mountainous type, and also the littoral or tidal types are based on the variation in relief feature. First four are related with the variation in rainfall, and last two, mountain forest or mixed forest and tidal or mangrove or littoral forest, are related with the relief feature. You have to remember, first of all, it's a climate, it is needed more than 200 centimeter rainfall, as like the evergreen trees. More than 200 centimeter rainfall it is needed for the growth of these type of trees, the littoral trees or the mangrove type of trees. By hearing these names, you don't forget the same, only it is littoral type or the mangrove type. It is known as littoral or the mangrove type. And the temperature 26 to 29 degrees Celsius. Only these trees which are growing in the water at the same time on the land, stretching its roots towards from land to the water, that is why it is mangrove. It can grow both in land and the water. 26 degrees Celsius to 29 degrees Celsius areas of India it is growing well. And the characteristics are, it is known as phenematophorus. Phenematophorus term you have to remember, I think you have studied already. Then also, that means the breathing roots are there. By the roots it is breathe. These trees are, the plants are, trees are breathing through its roots, and which act as a respiratory organ as its root. That is why it is called a phenematophorus. Breathing roots are phenematophorus, first one it is, you can write. And a clumsy type of roots are there, slit or clumsy type of roots are there and remain submerged under the water. The roots are moving under the water. The slit-like roots remain submerged under the water. That is water they can live on the water. Also on the delta region it is found. Most of the delta region where there is the river meets with the sea, that area, mouth of the river, the tidal trees are found. Seen at the low tide areas are also. So this type of trees are found at the low tide areas. And this tangled mass of roots helps the plant to survive the shifting mud of coastal region. Slit type of roots, clumsy type of roots, it is helpful for the survival of shifting mud of the coastal region. And they are dense also. These are the main characteristics. And main species are Sundari tree. It is Sundari tree. It is a type of tree which found in the tidal area in India. Sundari, it is tree only. You don't confuse with this name. Sundari trees. And other trees are Gojan, Hindal, Keora, Agar are the other types of trees which we can found in the tidal or mangrove type of trees which found in India. Sundari tree, it is very important. It is very very hardwood tree. Sundarban delta regions of India it is found, and it is very hard and strong and durable also. Sustainable it is. It is long lasting, and it is used for boat making, as these type of trees are growing in the watery area. That is why it is resistant to the water. That is why it is used for the making boat building it is using. And other trees are also important. Gojan, Hindal, Koyra. You have to remember Sundari tree, a typical tree which found in the tidal or mangrove or littoral area. Typical tree asked means you have to write Sundari tree only. Atypical tree asked means. So most of the question paper it is asking, you have to write it. Now we can see the areas wherever it is found. The deltaic regions of Ganga, Brahmaputra areas, delta region, Ganga river region, it's a delta in West Bengal. Sundarban area it is, Sundarban area, this only. This area mostly in India found in Sundarban area, Sundari trees are found. It's a good scenery area. Most of the trees found here. Mangrove trees are found here. And Brahmaputra delta region also can found. Godavari, Krishna Godavari delta region in the eastern side, Kaveri delta region in eastern side, we can found such a type of tree. Sundarban, you have to mark it during the mark work where the, an area of in India where mangrove littoral type of tidal trees are found, you have to mark Sundarban area. Or this area also, Brahmaputra delta region, Godavari delta region, and Kaveri delta region you can. So in further clarification with this map you can identify Sundarban, Mahanadi in Orissa, Krishna Godavari and Kaveri in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Tamil Nadu. Then the delta region of Mangalore, Ratnagiri river side, Goa Mangalore side. Even in Kashmir, sorry, in Gujarat area also, mangrove trees are found. Gujarat, see, deltaic area. West, in Gujarat, state also you can write, based on this. I think it is clear. Eastern side of, and western side also. Eastern side mostly the mangrove types are found in India. So, tidal trees, it states, I think it is clear. Delta region, Sundarban Delta, and along the eastern coast, these areas, Krishna Godavari, Kaveri Delta region, we can found. I think it is clear. So, the types of forests, six types of forests based on rainfall and variation in relief feature, we have described six types. Moving to the next topic, that is the forest resources in India. First of all, forest is a wealth of the country, collective wealth of the country. Forests are one of the most important natural resources of our country. That is why it is a collective wealth of our country. So remember this. It's important. And also, depletion of forest cover by the deforestation, that is very important. See, unfortunately, almost it is 21% only in India's forest cover. The effective forest cover as revealed by all kinds of surveys is hardly between 12% to 14% only. Actually, 33.3% should be. Beginning of the chapter we were discussing that. Due to the different primitive methods of cultivation, slash and burn method and urbanization, unauthorized cutting down of trees, it is deteriorating the trees from India. Depletion of forest cover is termed as a deforestation. And in order to conserve the flora and fauna in our country, it has to raise some of the preventive measures. Some preventive measures we have to take down. For example, Vana Mahotsav in India, afforestation programs and reafforestation, replanting programs in India, it is very important. So essential ecological balance it has to maintain, required to protect our forest resources. That is why environmental and endangered wildlife can be protected. So that the government has to set up central board of forestry after the independence, suddenly after the independence, after 5-year plan it is adopted. Many policies have been evolved to implemented for the conservation of the forest, like Vana Mahotsav in India and afforestation and reafforestation programs. See, Vana Mahotsav program started in 1950. In India. Under this program, all government organizations are supposed to plant trees in the months of July and August. The governmental organizations want to plant the trees month of July and August. Why this July and August? Because during the rainy season it is to plant new plants. So Vana Mahotsav it is celebrating. It is started in 1915 onwards. Other one it is afforestation programs we have to conduct. Afforestation program, it is under this scheme, program has been proposed to plant trees in Rajasthan, West UP and Kutch desert and prevent the soil erosion. That is afforestation programs taken in our country. Reafforestation programs are also preventing the primitive methods like slash and burn or zooming method and wrong methods of plowing in northeastern India, indiscriminate cutting down of trees. Also, we have to prevent, that is why these reafforestation methods are started in this area. And saplings of plants should be filled with the areas, fields. Reafforestation, it is started. Replantation, it is started in India. And also, another one movement, it is CIPCO movement. In order to protect, prevent the, conserve the trees, the CIPCO movement, it is started under the eminent leadership of Sundarlal Bahuguna. It is started CIPCO movement, an NGO, non-governmental organization in India, to save the trees. The environmentalist called Sundarlal Bahuguna started CIPCO movement in 1974, remember. And the women on these North Indian areas, in especially our state, women in Reni in North India, where they rescued the trees by covering the trees wherever the people are trying to cut the trees, they were covering the trees. And this is a living example for the general public awareness programs. Commendable progress has taken place for the protection of the trees, deforestation of the trees. So these are the points related with that. Conservation of forest, it is important. Here we have to remember many points. Conservation of forest. As like the wild animal also conserved. Conservation of forest includes many points. NRSA, that is National Remote Sensing Agency, that is denoting that the country is losing about 1.3 million hectares of forest every year. 1.3 million hectares of forest cover it is declining in India each year. That should be conserved. And this will be detrimental to our national interest, so that we have to preserve it. And program of forest conservation, it is includes forest conservation programs, it is adopted by the government. The government measures have taken different programs. Under the government programs, preventive measures are taken. Act on destruction, it has taken. So biosphere reserves are taken place. Biosphere reserves, forest reserved forest areas, national forest areas, protected areas, protect both trees and species. Several forest regions have been declared reserved forest in India. Rajasthan reserved forest cover about 400 lakh hectares in India, whereas protected forest areas covers about 200 lakh hectares of India. In order to prevent the forest deforestation, it is act on destruction, prevent diseases of trees are also biosphere reserves, forest and reserve forest, it is taken place. And planting more and more trees, it is adopted. Poaching of the forest area, that means occupying the area for the cattle raising and other purpose, it is poaching of forest area to be controlled. Controlling different area for the different purpose, for the occupying the land area, forest area, that is also controlled, and afforestation methods also taken place. Another one is the sericulture. Sericulture, practice of timber farming. Sericulture meaning it's a timber farming. For the economic purpose of the wood or the timber, it has to plant. Silviculture, it is known as. It is to get sustained yield of timber, silviculture, it is practiced. For timber farming, it is silviculture, it is started. A new method. Development of green belt areas are also another one, it is. For the forest cultivation. All the trees mature together and make it clear cutting areas. Green belt areas, it is found. Apart from these measures, the Forest Research Institute, it was set up in different part of India. See, in Dehradun, Research Forest Research Center, it is set up. So, another method it is. Encourage Vanamahav also, another one. And ban slash unban method, also another forest conservation. You have to remember this. So, these areas also, some of the question can ask. Another topic, it is related with the forest products and their uses. It is easy only. It is providing employment opportunities many of the areas, and they are storehouse of timber for house making and furniture, fuel, foods, etc. It is commonly getting. Also, it is providing thousands of people for the employment opportunities and the source of income also. Different way it is a source of income, and they provide raw material to many industries, paper industries and pulp industries, raw materials for the different industries. And it is providing, maintaining the ecological balance, ecological purifying the air and ecological maintaining the ecological balance. And also many other products like beeswax, materials for the dyeing and tanning, we studied shelter for the wildlife, it is giving. Okay, and also cleans the environment, purifying the environment, and also conserving water in subsoil. These are the uses of the trees and the forest. Checking the wind erosion, remember, these are the uses. Now the problems of the Indian forestry, that is also we have to discuss problems of Indian forestry. We can discuss a little fast. Low forest cover area is the first problem. The forest cover area is only 21.02% only. World average it is 35% only. Overgrazing is another problem. Cattle rearing most of the area, that is why the areas are, it is a depletion, it is taking place. Shifting cultivation. The primitive method we have described a problem. It is growing demand for agricultural land. That is another one. By the urbanization and industrialization, people demands more land areas. And the other one, it is urbanization and industrialization. Construction of hydroelectric projects in India. Many projects are there in India. Throughout the areas of forest cover area, it is moving the multipurpose projects in India. Hirakud project or any other projects. And human activities like mining, quarrying, etc. also threat for the problem for the Indian forestry. Quarrying, mining, building, construction, etc. That is also destroying the forest area. Then moving to the next one, the National Forest Policy in India. National Forest Policy in India. Sometimes it is not there in your book, textbook, which is provided, but some of the questions are asking based on this only. Since 1894 onwards, before the independence onwards, 18th century itself, the National Forest Policy it is prevailed in India. So for policy by the government to protect and conserve and develop the forest region in India, step which has taken place, afforestation and reforestation, and the National Forest Policy of 1988. Since in 1894 it is there, the important forest policy or the amendment it has taken in 1988 only, considering as a national heritage. The forest, national forest considered as the national heritage of India, control of erosion, checking the extension of the sand dunes in desert area by sand dunes increasing, expanding, the forest cover will be decreasing in India. That is why steps to create massive movement in forest management that has taken place in India. So these are the important national forest policy which has taken place in 1988, that you have to remember, National Forest Policy. Now there is another one program, Social Forest Programs in India, Social Forestry Programs in India. This is also not in your book, but you have to refer this. Some questions are asking, the objective to create awareness regarding conservation of forest and to meet the needs of the rural people regarding fuel and timber is the social forest program. So you have to remember that the social forestry program, it is related with the awareness program. This is important, awareness program regarding conservation, and also in order to make aware among the rural areas, village areas, need for conserving the forest in rural areas, and regarding fuel and timber, the social forestry programs are adopted in India. There is another one term other than the social forestry program, that is important. Agroforestry is another term which is used. Agroforestry also important. So what is the difference between social forestry program and agroforestry? Social forestry program, it is related with the awareness program among the rural public. But agroforestry, it is an integrated approach of using the interactive benefits from combining trees and shrubs with crops. It combines agriculture and forestry technologies. It is combining agriculture and forestry technologies, create more diverse, productive and profitable land system. It is a comprehensive system which is adopted to improve the forestry and its technology. Productive and profitable land system as a narrow definition. Trees are the firm. It is also known as treason. Here one of the link it was given, you can see that you can move to this link in YouTube. There you will get more videos related with this topic, related with the types of vegetation found in India. So these are the main points we have to remember here. So one of the question it is asking here, which type of forest are mostly found in India? Tropical deciduous forest dominates in mostly in India. They can be classified into two divisions. So the areas are also given, tropical deciduous forest. At a glance it is given in this map where are the areas. By that it is desert type or semi-desert type, mountainous type, you can see here, mountainous type, deciduous type, tropical deciduous type, you can see here with the blue color, evergreen type with the dark green color, it is given here. So that is also you can see. And what is the economic importance of the forest? Just a revision, we can see this. Economic importance, you know, forests play an important role in the economic development of the country. They provide several goods, which we have seen many points. Next point, it is related with what values do forest add to the our life. Some of the points are given, that is also you can see here. So these are the points here you have to remember. So this is the end of this chapter, that is the natural vegetation of India. You have to revise it well properly. You have to remember this, and you have to write the short notes also based on this, that six types of vegetation. For first four main, it is based on the variation of the rainfall, and the next it is based on variation of relief feature only, that you have to study. So if you are writing the short notes based on these slides, it will be easy to learn. I think you will do this. It is clear also. So this is the end of this chapter. Thank you. Take care.